Like, what happened that you weren't able to finish school? Tell me what happened.
Oh, I had to go to work.
You had to go to work?
Yeah.
Doing what?
To support my family.
Yeah? So...
Not what I wanted, but that was my choice.
Thank you so much.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what I did until I got drafted in 1942.
Mm-hmm.
So, left here in the month of March, went to Niagara Falls, where we got measured for clothes, got on the troop train. It went from Niagara Falls to Fort Eustis, Virginia, which is around the Chesapeake Bay. I spent the next 3 months there in boot camp. Teaches how to be a soldier, it's about all, nothing else. Left there in the month of July on a troop train. And it went from Fort Eustis, which I say is the Chesapeake Bay, all the way to California on a 6-day train ride. There was no facilities on the train. It was real, an old-fashioned train. We got into California, got into a separation center and directed us to the dock and got on a boat. The boat name was U.S. Bear Lane. It had 1,500 civilians on it. The rest were all military. It was a 6-day trip into Hawaii. They took us into a separation center. It was called Tent City. It's not an elaborate thing, but this is the place where they took you so they can separate you to go into a permanent camp. So the way they did it, all the camps in Hawaii put in what people they wanted in their outfit. So I got into an anti-aircraft unit with two other of my friends that I went over to California with. I spent the next year and 3 months as a radar technician. In the month of December 1944, we boarded another ship. We packed our equipment, boarded another ship on a 17-day trip to the island of Saipan. We waited there a short distance for wherever orders it was. We found out we invaded Iwo Jima on the 17th of February, 1945. We stayed there for 3 months, and we were ready to go to the invasion of Iwo Jima. So we got on the ship, which was a 3-day trip. We got off the flight the same day President Roosevelt died, on April the 12th, 1945. We had to unload our equipment. I was a radar operator, so the radar was the last unit that they put into the bay of the LST. So we made camp on the outer portion of the island with three other units. We had four units, A, B, and C, and D were four units that went along with us. And well, we set up our equipment and started to do surveillance because the Japanese were still in the caves. And every night they would come out and looking for food mostly. But we had to work 24 hours a day. We practically slept in the radar because you never know when the Japs would come back and start putting their bombs out again, so they didn't do it. So we trained there for the entire time that I was there, and then all at once in the month of May, on the 21st of May, I was doing surveillance by myself on the radar. I encountered enemy aircraft at 200 miles out. I checked my IFF, and it was enemy aircraft. It was our enemy. Notified the battery commander, the gun crews went into action, and at 8 miles down, I picked up one aircraft, and battery commander gave the word to fire number two gun, I forget what one it was, and took him down within 8 seconds. I immediately got onto another aircraft and checked my IFF, and for sure he was a Japanese aircraft. We took it down. They never came back. That was the last of the time they came there to try to cause a little havoc. And by the time we started to say we thought we could pack up and go into the main island, because they were going to decide to move us into Japan, then they decided to leave us where we were. And then the Marines left there, went to Okinawa invasion. And then from that point on, we found out about on the 5th of August, I was doing surveillance by myself on the radar. And I heard a terrible roar up in the sky. And I could count B-29s in squadrons of 10. And I counted them across the sky. There were 40 B-29s. As I counted the entire squadron, 830 B-29s, all going to Japan. The following day, on the 6th, on that particular day, was my little sister's birthday, her. She's 15 years old. The following day, I'm working on the radar by myself. I had it in an automatic mode. I picked up two aircraft at 37,000. I looked in the scope. We had a scope on the outside of the radar. I could not read the inscription on the plane, but I knew it had a girl on it, but I could not make out what it was, and he had an escort, another B-29 behind him. 2 days later, or the next day, we had a radio. We found out that he dropped the bomb. But he did not come back on the same route. But the next day, our captain called us to the battery area, which we never went to, and told us that the Japanese were going to surrender. On the 9th of August, they did the surrender. And it was time to break camp. So we buttoned up all the equipment that we had and started to break everything down to start going home. On the 9th of September, I got an appendix attack. I ended up in the hospital for a whole week. During the time that I was there, my two buddies that operated the radar with me, it was a three-man operation, they got on the ship and started to go home. So I was in the hospital 7 days. I finally got out, and I had to wait for transportation to leave the island. I did not leave again until the 3rd of October. They put me on a small aircraft to the island of Saipan, where I waited for more transportation. I waited there 27 days to get on transportation. Finally, we got orders to board a ship, and it was a ship was out to sea. We had to go out and get on the flatbed to go out there. So we look out, and it's a big aircraft carrier. So he says, the guy that was going to put us on threw the net over the side, and it's about 40 foot up in the air. He says, you want to go home? He says, that's it. So I had to climb that rope all the way up to 40 feet to get up on the top deck. I spent the next 15 days on that ship. The fourth day out, it was Thanksgiving Day. It was the first time we had a meal in almost 3 years. A decent meal, we had turkey. I'll never forget that. Anyway, it was a 17-day trip from where we were, because we were the other side of the world, into California. And before we got there, about 10 miles out from the beach, there was a bunch of people was on an open board ship. They had the jazz band on there. They were playing all kinds of music, and they were cheering us on as the aircraft carrier was coming in to dock. So when it did dock, I spent the next 3 days there to get to a separation center to get out. So they put us on a train. I ended up in Camp Atterbury, Indiana, on 3 days later. I got fitted for new clothes, because what I had was really old and it needed a lot of washing. I hadn't seen it in 3 years, but it fitted me with new clothes, got on a train, and overnight I came into Batavia. And from Batavia, I stopped at my sister's house and went home.